Christmas. Well, first of all, 2020 has been probably one of the worst years of my life. First starting off with, I think in January, we lost the late great Kobe. Then in March, they came up with the COVID-19, and that was pretty hard. And then in July, Tonya had got a big hit on COVID, and she was in a coma for almost a week, right?
4 days.
4 days. Well, it felt like a week, but she was in the hospital for how long? Like
23 days.
23 days, and the doctors didn't feel that she was going to make it. So that was big for me because, to actually go through it, you really don't know. Me and my sons couldn't sleep. We couldn't eat. During that time with COVID, you wasn't even allowed in the hospitals to see the patients. So that was kind of difficult for us, pretty hard. So we really didn't know what she was doing and how she was doing. And during that time, we constantly getting information on other people was passing away from COVID-19. So. It was pretty hard, and of course, through the grace of God, she was able to pull through, and that was good. And now leading to Christmas, Christmas is a little more priceless this year for me, more than price tag. And the reason why I say priceless is because it's not about the gifts that's under the tree, it's about the gift that I have next to me. And to me, having her here that's one of the best Christmas gifts that I can say. And I still wouldn't mind having some more gifts under the tree, but having her here is a great gift. So Christmas this year means a lot. Showing you a lot about life, about stuff to be thankful for other than material items. Thankful for your family and my grandbaby, Layla, seeing her happy, and my oldest son, Al, and his wife, Sawinka. Seeing them happy, and of course my baby boy Marquise, mm-hmm. that spent up all our money,
right.
We're looking forward to see him happy with his gifts on Christmas as we crying because we had to pay for them. So Christmas is it's good, but for me it's more of a priceless thing this year more than anything, based on what we've been through and what we was able to overcome. So what you think?
Well, this year has been very trying and very humbling for me. Again, like you said, Christmas this year is so much more than gifts. It's being here today, being alive today, to be able to be around your loved ones. You know, my husband, my children, my granddaughter, my mom, my dad, my sister, my whole entire family, during the time that I was going through with COVID, I had such a great support team from my family, just being there for my husband and my children. My family kind of stepped in, and they did everything.
Right now at 5:30, a Jacksonville woman is sharing her story of recovery, having to learn to walk and to talk again after testing positive for COVID-19.
God can turn it around, and he is still working miracles because I am a miracle.
And she spoke with News 4 Jax reporter Marilyn Parker.
Marilyn is here with us. Marilyn, why did this woman want to share her story now?
Well, you know, it's really an incredible story to begin with. And she wanted to talk to her support system at her family and at UF Health for thanking them for getting her through this very rough process, but also because this virus is still with us. Cases are rising, and she wants to encourage those dealing with it right now to keep fighting. This was LaTanya Harris in the hospital after testing positive for COVID-19. She spent 23 days there, four of them under a medically induced coma.
I was one of the patients that was right there at death.
It started with her son, later pictured here wearing a My Mom Beat COVID-19 t-shirt. He was feeling sick in July and got better, but his mom grew weak.
I don't remember really getting as sick as I was. I just remember waking up and I had all these tubes all over me. Every time I swallowed, it felt like I was swallowing a piece of plastic.
Her condition worsened and it was left up to her husband to decide the next steps.
They told my husband that if we put her in a medical induced coma, this will give her the ability to rest and we will fight for her.
To this day, she's grateful for the medical team at UF Health. She even did a story thanking them for their help.
The staff there began to be almost like your family.
Though she was stronger, it was a challenge to relearn how to speak and walk after leaving the hospital. It wasn't until September when she got the strength back in her legs to move on her own.
Numbers are increasing. How does it make you feel to hear that we're still dealing with this today?
It's very scary to know that it could get worse, that we may not have seen the worst of COVID.
But she says she hopes her life-changing and humbling experience will be an inspiration to those battling the virus.
I'm looking at where I was, but I'm not there no more.
Harris says she actually tested positive again after leaving the hospital, but the worst of her fight was over. She wants people to know this is a very real virus, and while she's grateful for her family and the team at UF Health, she says it's up to everyone else to keep doing their part. Joy?
Gosh, Marilyn Parker, thank you.
Because when I first got out of the hospital, I couldn't walk. I had lost my speech. I couldn't walk. I couldn't do anything on my own. My mom and my husband and my aunts would help even give me a bath. I wasn't even mobile to even do that. I went through physical therapy at home because when I got out of the hospital, we wound up staying in my mom's house because my mom and my aunts, while Alba was at work, my mom and my aunts would take care of me. My dad would take me to my appointments, so they kind of like stepped in and did things that I wasn't able to do. You know, I used to can dry myself, or I can cook, or I can bathe myself, you know, but I wasn't in a position to do that, you know, so it took me some time to kind of get myself back, to get back to being me. You know, after getting out the hospital, I think we wound up staying to my mom's house about 2 months, maybe about 2 months. We stayed in my mom's house. At that particular time when I left my mom's house, I was done with physical therapy. I was still on a cane and a walker, but I was a little bit more mobile to kind of get around, you know, kind of pushing myself to kind of get around to doing things that I used to do. And when I got home, it kind of pushed me a little bit more, you know, to kind of move a little bit more and do, you know, different little things. Still wasn't able to, you know, stand up in the kitchen and cook and, you know, clean. So my family was still doing all of that for me and my husband and my children. They were still cooking. My friends were, you know, bringing food. My family was bringing food, you know, just helping us out. As I went on and days and days and days of going on, I start progressing and, you know, getting more mobile, you know, getting to doing the things that I love to do. So it was hard. It was hard. It was a struggle. But, you know, a lot of prayer, a lot of you know, just sacrifice, a lot of sacrifice, you know, on me and my husband. It was a lot of sacrifice, you know, but through the grace of God, we made it. Through the grace of God, we made it.
You ready, ready, ready?
Yes, sir.
I can do what?
All things.
Through whom?
Christ.
Who what?
Strengthens me.
I can do what?
All things.
Through whom?
Christ.
Through what?
Strengthens me.
I can what?
All things.
Through whom?
Christ.
We're scribbling?
Me.
Me. Father God, we thank you tonight. We give you praise. Oh, Father, we thank you for our audience tonight, our spectators, our fans, our family, our coaches, and our players. On both sides, Father, competitive. The William Maggie Reigns, Reebok, John Reebok Trojan. And God, we thank you now as we go out and do what you bless us to do. Keep us safe. Keep us agile. Keep us motivated, oh Father. Uh-huh. And a lot of greatness within us that to come out to give you glory as a team. Cement it together. Our Father,
our Father,
John in heaven,
John in heaven,
hallowed be thy name,
hallowed be thy name,
thy kingdom come,
thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
thy will be done,
in earth,
on earth,
as it is in heaven,
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day,
give us this day,
our daily bread,
our daily bread,
give us our debts,
give us
our debts, give us
our debts,
and lead us not,
give us not,
in the temptation,
in the temptation,
but deliver us,
deliver us,
from all evil,
from all evil,
for God is the kingdom,
God is the kingdom,
the power,
the power,
and the glory,
and the glory,
amen,
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 amen.
Ready to play defense, folks.
How y'all feel?
Ready to play defense, folks.
Y'all see what the girl's doing?
Make
1-2-2. That's what they're going to play the boys. Let me explain something to you. They're going to foul you, and they're going to foul you hard. Ain't no sense in complaining. You got it?
Yes, sir.
They're going to foul you hard. So we got to do a better job of making free throws. I can almost guarantee you we'll be in 1-1 for the first quarter over with. But we got to sprint back. All they want to do is run, push the ball down the floor. You got it?
Yes, sir.
So we got to, what, rebound? Got to make free throws. But most of all, we got to play what?
Defense.
Period. We got to communicate. Right? Got to communicate. We got to play Reebok basketball tonight. It ain't much that needs to be said. I don't know why I'm talking so much now. Maybe because, you know, somebody looking at me right now. But I ain't really got to say nothing. I shouldn't have to do that. Right?
Yes,
everybody should have something to play for. Right?
Yes, sir.
Football, you definitely got something to play for. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right? Y'all know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You got to. You got, this is what you come here for. You're playing this type of stuff. This is what you come here for. Y'all see it? This ain't time for nobody to take a nut roll today. Everybody got to play. So basically, we got to pick up from where we left off last night. Period. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Period. We got to have all this enthusiasm. We got to have that right now going forward. Listen to your coaches. You don't need to be here or there or there or there. Because if you're here, there, and there, guess where you're going to be?
Bench.
That means you ain't focused. You make a bad pass, who cares?
Get back.
You miss a shot, who cares? Get back. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right? That's what it's about. Pick your brother up, period. Whoever it is, pick them up. You got me?
Yes, sir.
So we should be good.
Yes.
Trust me, I got a real good feeling. Like my oldest son used to say when he was little, I got a funky fresh feeling. Got a funky fresh feeling. So let's play hard. Let's get out. We ain't biting out. They tall. We ain't biting out. We going 22 right off the rim. You got me?
Yes, sir.
And we moving. Talk.
Half of four.
Half. Talk. You gotta talk. You got it? You gotta talk. Keep. You gotta talk. Play for yourself. Play for your player. But most of all, play for your school. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Play for your school. That's all that matters. Everything else will take care of itself. Got me?
Yes, sir.
Coach.
I'm good, Coach.
Play together, stay together, fellas. That's it. Yes. Play together, stay together on both ends. It'll work itself out. You got to get this one. You got to have it. We already know how important this game is. So it shouldn't be us having to talk to y'all to motivate y'all to have y'all ready to play. It's a must win. It is what it is. It's a must win. But it's going to take everybody in this room for us to get it done.
So this year, I am so forever grateful to even just be here, to even be alive today, to even be able to speak. You know, I'm just so thankful and I'm so grateful for all the many blessings that God has stored upon me, and how He is continually healing my body, how He's continually blessing me. I truly, truly thank God for Him each and every day. I thank God for my husband for being such a great caretaker. You know, he sacrificed a lot. You know, he went through a lot. You know, the caretakers go through just as much as the patient. And he was an excellent caretaker for me. My mom, excellent caretaker. My aunts. You know, everybody just kind of like stepped in. So this year, my heart is so filled with love. My heart is so filled with peace. I just thank God for being here. I truly do. I thank God for being here, you know, because it could have went a whole nother way. And I just thank God that He allowed me to continue to be here to honor Him, you know, because He's the one that did it. He's the one that did everything for me when I couldn't do it for myself, you know. When I couldn't breathe, He was breathing for me. When I couldn't talk, He was speaking for me. You know, so those little things that we do on a day-to-day basis has become so humbling to me, has become such a blessing to me, just being able to get out of the bed now and walk on my own. Talking on my own, I'm able to do things that I used to do, not everything that I used to do. You know, I still have some struggles and still have some ways to go, but I thank God where I am today. So Christmas this year is just, you know, been extra humbling for me, and I thank God for the gifts of life. I thank God for the gift of love. I thank God for the gift of peace, and I thank God for family. Because that's what prayed me through, family, the strong family support that we had. It was remarkable.
Absolutely.
Very first kiss. I want to thank you, baby.
You make it feel like Christmas. I want this right here.